buddy. So, you know, a couple weeks ago, we lost a great artist, and just recently, I think, Monday, we lost Bill Withers, so I wanted to play that song to start this off. First of all, he seemed to know something that we don't, which is that this song is so important for times like this. So I think it's really appropriate, and I hope you guys are all doing well and you're all leaning on each other and we can lean on each other. And that's kind of what this show is about. It's about coming together and having a good time and talking about all sorts of stupid stuff. But really, it's about enjoying each other's company. So do me a favor, let me know where you're watching from. If you can you can just type your country's name, or you can put the flag, but it's easier to read if you just write it down, because I don't know all the flags. Okay, so welcome to Coffee with Kendall. This is Coffee with Kendall, and this episode is dedicated to Bill Withers. So shout out Bill. Hope you guys are doing all right. It's been I don't know, quite a few days, and we're still moving. We're chugging along. All right, let's see where you guys are watching from. Austria. I think I saw Switzerland. Minnesota. A couple people in a row from Minnesota. It's okay, Brittany. Brittany has to go. She's at work. That's fine. East Tennessee. Honduras. Mexico. Wow. All right. Of course, as you guys know, I have my extra large coffee. So life is good. All right. Yeah, like I was saying, we're in day whatever of quarantine. And I think hopefully everyone's doing the right thing and staying home. And I think that's really the best we can do at this point. Hope everyone's safe and healthy. And doing all right and leaning on each other. That's kind of what I wanted to make that point with that song. So with that being said, I think that we should do what we always do on Coffee with Kendall and talk about the articles of the day. These are things that I've been reading that I'm loving. So if I can just tap the thing. Looking for my buddy boy, Charlie. We're going to join in with the Coffee with Kendall Instagram, which is currently being done by Charlito.
How are you, brother?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. How are you feeling today?
I feel good.
Really?
Yeah, I'm a little tired.
Where are you at?
I'm at home.
Fuck yeah, bro. That's it. I was telling Nicole yesterday, and I told a friend, like, I don't know, like, if that's, like, a really, like, bro, it's too soon joke, or yeah, it's appropriate right now. Yeah. I don't know.
We're home.
We're good.
One thing that's for sure is that if you text somebody and they don't respond,
they don't want to speak with you. Yeah. It's like, bro, right now is like that exact time that we should use for stuff like that.
Because I would say most people, they're not busy right now.
No.
Although, you know what? I got to be honest. I've been pretty busy.
I've been busy too, but it's different because you're not like, you're in one place. So yeah, you just have you, like, so you're working whatever you're doing, but you're like looking at your phone and stuff like that. So I think if someone doesn't get back to you right now, it's either because they don't want to or because they really don't want to.
Yeah. Yeah. It's one of those two reasons.
Probably it is.
But you know, I've been busy. I've been working on music a lot and,
I know,
you know,
very good.
Planning this, I'd like to say that planning this show is a lot of work, but it's really not. I want to do more. Like, I want like an intro song. I need to make like a Coffee with Kendall song. You know?
How would it be?
Maybe like it's Coffee with Kendall with your favorite host, Kendall Schmidt. That's kind of weird. I'll make one.
Please do, dude.
And I really want like a cool like graphic content like Miley has on her show.
Dude, let's do it. I mean, we have time right now.
Yeah, I don't know how to make that. So.
I have no idea. But like, do we have enough time to learn? That's the question.
Yes, yes. We have time to learn. But hey, let's jump into the articles.
Dude, I think this is great.
So this, being that it is Coffee with Kendall, I thought that this was a great article. And by the way, guys, most of the articles I read are pretty stupid. Because look, in the news right now, there's a lot of craziness going on, so it's nice to see something that doesn't have anything to do with what we're all dealing with, which is
like this.
Not yeah, like that.
Hey, that's, finally,
that's a carrot, I mean, if I've ever seen one.
Dude, look at that. No, but look at this. Finally, a great lip sync for the mature woman.
Nine creative uses for old coffee grounds. So if you just scroll down, Charlie, we'll just kind of skip to the uses. Where it says,
boom.
All right, so here we go. Use coffee grounds to remove grease or oil from your hands, I guess. Use coffee grounds to eliminate bad odors.
But this works.
It does work, but then your stuff smells like coffee, which, you know. Fertilize your garden with coffee grounds. Now, this is something that I'm going to do. As you saw from my post talking about today's episode, I was watering the garden. And I'm going to use this technique.
Please do. And I think it works like a charm.
Yes.
I didn't know this.
Repel insects with coffee grounds. That's another reason why I'm going to use it in the garden, because my greens have been getting eaten a little bit. So.
So if you use it as a fertilizer, also it repels insects?
I hope.
That's great.
Use coffee grounds to remove fleas. Wow.
From like... your dog or stuff like that?
I guess so.
Wow. How do you do it? Like, did you give them coffee and they're getting like really nervous and they just jump up their dog?
Yeah, they just like shake a lot.
They're like, and they like just like loosen up?
Yeah.
Okay.
Make an exfoliating body scrub using coffee grounds.
Actually, that makes sense. I mean, you have happy and you can do something with happy and coffee.
Exactly. Exactly. It's a good idea. Minimize cellulite appearance with coffee grounds.
I'm not going to lie to you. I'm going to use that one.
Yeah. You have a lot of cellulite, Charlie.
Dude, quite a little bit, especially on the buttocks area.
Use coffee grounds as an anti-aging eye treatment. Love that.
I'm going to use it.
You definitely need that as well. Go ahead and cook with coffee grounds. Okay. I think that's 9, right?
Yeah, that's 9.
Okay. Well, that's interesting. Anyway, I hope you guys find that interesting. You can Google that and do all that.
Stay informed by CNN.
Fareed Zakaria. Here's the second one. This is a great article I've seen pop up in a couple different like news outlets. Yes. Moon bases could be built using pee-pee from astronauts.
Don't you love the word urine?
I do, but I think pee-pee's way funnier.
Is there a video?
I don't know what this video is.
Let's see. I think it's gonna work. Oh yeah.
Oh, we don't have time for it anyway. Let's skip it.
No longer have to worry flushing too much toilet paper.
Wait, what?
People are like, I'm not trying to get advertised to. So basically the concept is that taking anything extra up to the moon, costs a lot of money and it takes a lot of effort. So if you could just take the materials you need to build, and then of course urine has urea in it, which they could use as a binder for the moon dust that exists on the moon to make a moon base.
Dude, that's incredibly interesting, actually.
Yeah.
And it's like absolutely self-sustainable if you think about it.
Yeah, so this is the kind of stuff I'm into. You know that. Let's go to the third article.
I think that's amazing.
Yeah. All these advertisements.
What? Look at this. Like, it's full of them. Like, we don't believe in that.
Let's go through this one kind of quickly because we got 10 options here. But 10 of the happiest countries in the world ranked. So if anyone who's watching this is from these countries, I'm super jealous. So Finland.
Wow.
Yes. I mean, look how happy these places look. Advertisements. Stop it.
Dude, I don't know what this is. How do I, like, get rid of this? What is happening? I'm sorry.
It's all right. I know these advertisements just pop up. But Denmark. Yeah, I'm sensing a theme here. Switzerland. Switzerland is beautiful. So I get that. Iceland. Norway. The Netherlands. Sweden. New Zealand, of course. New Zealand's beautiful.
I haven't been.
Austria.
Okay.
Luxembourg.
Luxembourg.
So basically what I'm gathering, with the exception of New Zealand, it's pretty much Scandinavian countries.
Do you want to say something that might make your country happier?
Yes.
I mean,
yeah, I would. Oh, I love this woman. Let's watch this real quick.
I love her so much.
Look at that dog.
Dude. Everything about this is just pure happiness.
By the way, I followed her, so I'm very into this.
I dream and I held you in my arms. Hold on, show it to me, and I'm like, dude, this is the best thing in the world.
She's so sweet. I want to be her friend.
Me too. That's the kind of thing we should be watching. Dude, I love you so much. Have an amazing day.
Hey, do me a favor. Let's send a message to all of our Spanish-speaking friends out there. A message of solidarity, if you would do that for me.
Absolutely, yes. Para toda la gente de Latinoamérica, de México, de toda la parte de habla hispana del continente y más allá, les mandamos un beso muy grande, un abrazo muy grande. Es importantísimo, y Kendall y yo siempre platicamos de eso, que se mantengan ahí los unos para los otros. Que piensen en ayudar a su vecino, que piensen en estar ahí simplemente. Es un momento para estar ahí en el que esto nos involucra a todos. Todos estamos juntos y los amamos. Y, like, just like keep going, right? Much yeah. Love and keep going. Just like that.
I love that. And I love you.
I love you so much, brother.
We'll talk soon.
Yes. Bye, bro.
Till the next episode.
Adios.
Adios.
Adios, cabrón.
All right. Love that. So let's not waste any time to bring in our special guest for this episode today. I love this girl. She is so fantastic. And we've known each other for many, many years now. And she is my one and only TV girlfriend. So I'm so happy to have her on the show. And we're going to share some memories and chat and hang. And it's just going to be great. So let me grab her real quick. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, Caitlin Tarver will be joining us. Oh.
Oh, that was very sweet.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you? How are you holding up?
I'm good. Yeah. I mean, you know, as good as can be, I guess. I have my coffee mug, but it's actually filled with water. Because I've already had two cups.
It's like the real talk shows where there's nothing actually in those cups.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Or maybe there's water. I don't know.
No, there's. But
do you notice sometimes in movies, like, where they're supposed to have a cup of coffee, but you know they didn't actually fill it with anything, so it's really light?
Yeah. Yeah.
And they'll be like, what do you mean? Just doing it all around. Like,
well, you know what? You know what really upsets me is when they do like in movies and they're like pouring, like I was watching a Zoe's Extraordinary Playlist and the mom popped a bottle of champagne or something and they're drinking it. And I'm like, that's not, I know for a fact that that's like sparkling grape juice.
Right.
And it just upsets me because I understand that you're making a TV show. You can't get drunk.
Right.
But whoever made that rule?
It would be a disaster and you know it. Because you know how long, because usually those scenes are like a dinner scene where there's like eight people. And then if everyone just gets drunker and drunker, it's already hard enough.
Well, that's
get
like
one of those scenes done.
what's the movie? Pineapple Express. Like, I think, I'm pretty sure they were smoking weed.
Yeah, like, probably. Like that was smoking. Probably an exception.
Yeah, I think I had heard something that they were actually smoking.
Oh, insider info?
Well,
and no, those are the kind of exclusives you get on this show.
Yeah, I don't know anybody.
Yeah, you do.
I don't know anybody.
I don't know anybody. I'm sitting in this leather chair. Can you hear it? Like,
Come here.
Oh, well.
Is that, are you sure that's the leather?
No comment.
So look, I know that you had a lot of stuff planned. You had some shows planned. You had all the, everything. Everything was lined up. And then, you know, so what would you say was the sort of like, I guess, grieving process of the things that you had lined up that are maybe kind of at least temporarily put on hold? You know, how did you handle that? Because I'm sure a lot of people had so many plans, whether it's going to see family or vacations or work things they were excited about or whatever.
Yeah.
So how did you kind of deal with that?
Just had full emotional breakdown.
Uh-huh.
No, I think the hardest part so far for me was like the first kind of weekend that everything was like dropping off. It was like, oh, this isn't going to happen. And then the tour is not going to happen. And then it was like, and you can't leave your house and you can't see your, it was just like, what, everything, like I had been looking so forward to going on that tour and it's like, yeah, everyone's losing things. Everyone's disappointed in some way and you can always compare it. But I think what you're getting at is everyone is allowed to feel sad at the loss of like whatever they had planned during this time. Cause it is sad. And it was very, it was just disappointing because it would, I don't know.
Well, what's funny is I was actually talking to one of the viewers a couple episodes ago. And she was saying, yeah, I'm just kind of upset. She's in Brazil. She goes, I'm kind of upset because I was getting ready to go to university, which she'll still go, of course, but it's just delayed. And I, first of all, I thought that was crazy because I couldn't wait to be done with school. So, I'm like, that's so great. I'm so happy for you, but you're insane.
Right. Like, I don't
know. I kid, of course. School is important, everybody. School is important. Yeah. I just want to make sure everybody knows that.
Yeah.
If you're into it, I'm happy for you.
Yes, very happy for you.
But didn't you have a song come out recently?
I did.
What was the song?
Yeah, I did. The song's actually called Feel Bad, which is kind of funny. it wasn't like a pivot because of the quarantine. I had planned to put it out for a while, but it just kind of was a coincidence. That came out last week and it's a new song for me.
Let's see if we can pull it up real quick.
Oh, you got it queued?
Get it queued up. If it hopefully will play on the speaker. Play.
Oh, no.
Well, this song is pretty quiet. How long is the intro?
Well, I really wanted to put out a completely silent song.
Oh, I am so stupid sometimes. I'm sorry. I wanted to, I just wanted to play on the actual like speakers behind.
Nice because, speaker. Yeah, that'd be good. Yeah.
You know, laptop sound. Oh, that's why it was on. Okay. I had my computer on mute.
Okay. Well, there we go. You know.
That's my friend.
I know her.
That's my baby.
That's my baby. I'm not proud of her.
I love the cover, by the way.
Thanks.
Well, I guess needless to say, everyone, if they haven't already heard the song, they should go check it out. It's Feel Bad by Caitlin Tarver.
Ah, thanks. Yeah, go check it out. There's a music video, and you can listen to it wherever you listen to your music. It's there. It'll be there.
Doesn't that almost seem redundant to say these days? It's like, you know where to find it.
Well, it does until, like, it feels very normal for people who are constantly, like, looking to find new music and listening to music, but for some people they don't. And like, I always, like, no matter how many times I talk about something or point people to something, there's inevitably a couple people are like, you put a song out, or
oh yeah,
can I listen to it on Spotify? And you're just like, yeah.
Well, it's like, well, you know how it is when you say like, somebody goes like, so what do you do? Like, believe it or not, I get into this conversation sometimes when I go golfing, because because if I'm going like by myself or with a friend, and it's like, usually I play like the par three course where you're just by yourself. But if you're playing like the full golf course, you usually end up getting paired with another group of people. And okay. So, you know, you have this 4.5 hours with these people, and inevitably the conversation comes up of, so what do you do? You know,
right.
One guy's over there. He's like, I'm in finance. And you're like, oh, sounds interesting.
Wow,
you know?
What's that like?
And then he's like, what do you do? Oh, I do music. And they're like professionally. And you're like, yeah.
Yeah.
That's my job. And they're like,
yeah,
they almost said like, and you can make money doing that. And I'm like,
right.
Kind of. Yeah. Well, not all the time. Sometimes.
Yeah. Sometimes you can. Yeah. I feel like pretty well rehearsed in like dealing with that question at this point.
Yeah.
But sometimes they always ask, still of course, just be like,
can I hear it? Where is it?
Would I have heard it anywhere?
Is it on YouTube?
Is it on the radio? You're like, no!
No, it's not on the radio, but
I wish it was.
I wish it was. Do you know anyone?
You would have to ask me what I have.
Yeah, you know what's funny? It's like next time that happens, I'm just going to say, yeah, so my name's Charlie Puth. I don't know if you've ever heard of my music.
I don't know if you've heard of me, but my name's Mr. Puth.
Hey, so did you happen to find any old photos at all? Or
I did. A lot of them are already like out, and I can't remember exactly how you add photos to this thing, but let me see.
Add photos to...
Like you can make the photo go into the chat.
You can?
Well, I thought you
did. Oh. Yeah, so it's on the right side. I didn't know that. Well, here's the one that I posted, right?
You know what? That's good. You know what I'm realizing? Look at us.
And I'm still wearing a beanie. Nothing has changed.
No. Yeah. Except you just don't have the bang.
You know, it's funny. Now I'm realizing this photo share thing. You really got to make sure that you have... How do I get rid of that? I don't want to do that anymore.
You really got to make sure you don't accidentally click on something that's next to it.
Well, it's like, look, sometimes I take screenshots of like weird shit when I'm like watching, I'm like looking at something, or it's like some random thing. And you can just imagine like, for example,
right.
This was my...
Gross.
This was my drink last night.
It looks like there's like spit in it.
Look, and here's me.
Take
here's
it away.
Me, here's oh me with God. Some popcorn. You know, oh it's just so you gotta
That's
be careful.
Just everyone's camera roll right now.
Yeah, you gotta be careful.
You know what I'm realizing is because I didn't start the chat, I don't think I can show the ones that I've set aside.
Well, let's see. I mean, I can always, I can pull up some.
Because I should have sent them to you first. And
yeah.
There's just a couple of, you know, pictures of us on set back in the day. There was one really good one of you eating with your shirt off.
What?
Yeah. Yeah, you were a real nightmare back then. I'm just kidding.
Okay, so, oh, first of all, this is great.
Oh, no. Oh, my God. I think that was the first episode.
That might have been the first one. That was, aww. Well, that was big time bad boy, I think. Something like that.
Yeah, I think that was, or I don't know if that was, I can't remember. But, yeah, that was one of the first, one of the earlier ones.
Here's, oh, here was your last appearance on Coffee with Kendall.
Oh, yeah. How cute.
There's us.
I remember showing up, like, it was not that, was it like 9 or 10 a.m.
It was like 9 o'clock.
Was it 9 a.m.? And I was like, I'm awake.
You know, hindsight is 20/20.
Yes.
That was a really stupid idea. But anyway, look at that.
Oh, yeah. Cool. Cool kids. Our hair.
Wait, okay. There's a lot of really good ones, actually. This is, speaking of sunglasses, here we're back again.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Don't we look cool?
Look how big my sunglasses are. Those were my personal sunglasses.
Yeah, they were.
But, you know, it was a while ago, so.
You know, I don't know if you know this, but I'm actually a famous meme or GIF artist. I don't know if you knew that.
No.
Yeah. You know, you know the heart pizza?
Yes. How could I forget?
That's me. So
that's you. Is that GIF used a lot, just like out of context?
Yeah, people use it as like a funny way of saying, oh, I love you or I miss you or something. And I often get that, I get that GIF sent to me by people who didn't know that I was a GIF. Like friends of mine,
right.
Who they're, it's most likely that they're coming across it trying to send one to a friend or something.
Yes.
Know?
Yes. I get that too. I did, like, one of my friends brought me into Giphy to like do a reaction pack.
Uh-huh.
And there's some pretty funny ones. Like I'll get probably once a week, like people are like, I didn't know you were a GIF. And it's like me just being insane. Like some of them are very,
it's just, it's ridiculous, by the way, that like people are way more excited about the fact that you're a GIF than the music that you put really hard work into.
Yeah.
You're famous.
I mean, I guess I get it. It's easier. It's more accessible. It's just right there.
I'm trying to find a couple more. There's a lot.
I know. I was like, maybe I'll show some exclusive.
Exclusive
behind the scenes.
Look at this. Look at this cutie.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. How does it feel to have a conversation with yourself?
Now that is a side bang. You're not the only one.
Yeah. Oh, no.
I think that picture was before we knew each other.
Yeah. Oh, that was definitely before. Yeah.
Yeah.
You had to have been maybe, what?
I was probably like 18, 19 in that.
18, 19? That's what I was going to say.
What'd you say? Like 13?
I was like 15, 16. I don't know.
I mean, close enough.
And by the way, like, for example, here's a picture. Well, it's too blurry, I guess. But like we weren't. No, it's too blurry. You can't even tell. Like,
what
pictures that we weren't actually in.
Oh, know? Like, have you seen that people Photoshop together?
Yeah. Like, yeah. We're not actually. Oh, here we go. Speaking of the heart-shaped pizza.
Oh. Oh, look at that. The love in my heart.
You know what's really sad is that we don't actually have these photos. These are just on the internet.
I think they are. I think they are from my, like, camera. Because I feel like back then I had, like, an actual. We didn't have, like, iPhones, did we? Or I didn't.
I started
taking them on a digital camera.
2008, I think I had, or 2009, I guess. I think I had an iPhone, but it was like the early one.
Right, you were cool.
Well. You said it. You said it, I didn't.
I probably still had like a knockoff BlackBerry or like a knockoff Sidekick.
Did you ever have a Sidekick?
No, I had a knockoff one.
I had it was like not a knockoff necessarily as much as it was just a sliding keyboard thing.
Right. I mean, those were cool.
There's a great photo I just found, but it comes up too small. Because it's a GIF thing.
You should maybe see if there are any good questions we could answer.
Yeah, does anyone have any questions?
Do you see the little question thing at the bottom?
Oh, yeah. People are, oh, yes. God, you're smart. Would you do the show for me?
I would if I could.
Somebody wants to know, how's the marriage life, Caitlin?
Oh, wow. It's good.
Can you click on them and they pop up? Oh, cool.
Oh, yeah. See? Look at that.
Wow.
Wow. I'm just giving tutorials.
Yeah, thanks. You should make a YouTube tutorial. Then you should put on like a really an unrecognizable accent like they always have. Hey guys, welcome to the tutorial of how to use Logic Pro. And you're like, I don't know, where are you from? Where is this guy from?
Yeah, it's like, is this a robot?
Yeah, sometimes they do that. So the marriage, the married life is good, basically.
It's good, yeah. It's great.
Okay, here we go. What's your favorite, what is our favorite memory together?
Oh gosh.
I was actually thinking about this beforehand because I was like, what's something that was really fun?
We had a lot of fun memes.
Yeah, I mean, pretty much it was fun the whole time. We really couldn't ever keep it together.
No.
On the show.
I mean, yeah, there were a lot of moments on set that were like, where we just could not stop laughing.
You know what I think is a crazy memory was the how odd it felt filming the Big Time Goodbye episode where Worldwide was the song. And like looking back now at that video and you being like, you know, and then me being like like, that was just so, hey, Jake Scott's on here. What's up,
Jake Scott?
Oh, Jake
Scott and Rachel Scott. Hi, guys.
Rachel Scott.
What's up, guys?
What's up? Hey, friends. You know, this was before the quarantine. I had talked to Jake a couple times about, we should get together. And we talked about you. We should all get together and make a song. And then, you know.
And now look at us. We goofed. And we never did it. Now who knows when we can.
This is a really easy one. Right,
wait. I want to say another thing about the Worldwide video that was very funny was you guys were, some of the shots were in slow-mo. And so to be able to film in slow-mo, you have to film it live double speed.
Yeah.
And so you guys all had to be like in your all white, like trying to be really brooding and sexy, but also singing along to a double speed version of Worldwide. And I was dying. And I feel like you guys were like so annoying or so annoyed.
Yeah.
Because you were like, ugh. Because you were like, I've been thinking about Worldwide. And like, you have to be, your face has to be as if you're singing it in normal singing. It was just, oh, it was so funny to watch and so nice to not have to be the one who had to do that.
There has to be a better way to do that.
I don't think there is.
I kept thinking, like, this is how all of these music videos.
I feel like I do have a video of that somewhere in my archives, and I'll have to dig it up because it was so funny.
You're in your filing cabinets?
In my files. I'll, dig through my file drawer. favorite cereal? I don't know, like, I haven't eaten cereal much. I eat a lot of granola forever, now. But I mean,
Lucky Charms were always my favorite.
Yeah, like Lucky Charms, or I randomly like Apple Jacks.
Chex. I also Apple liked Jacks. Oh, Apple Jacks. Ooh, you know I did an Apple Jacks commercial when I was a kid.
You did?
I did.
Oh, isn't that nice?
Yeah.
It's like we knew we were destined.
Yeah.
To be friends.
Did you always know you wanted to be in Apple Jacks commercial? Yes, From a young age, I
knew I wanted that.
Let's see here. I'm trying to
Jake
find...
Scott said he's still down to write.
We can do a Zoom thing.
What?
We can do a Zoom sesh.
Yeah, we can do a Zoom sesh. I haven't done one of those yet. We should try it out.
Oh, man. It's something.
Yeah. Imagine it'd be tough. Okay, any more questions that are good?
Oh, here we go. Can you answer this for me?
Okay, well, one, it was New Zealand.
Yeah.
And I had to leave because I was going off to star. I feel like Joe was going to do a movie, right?
It was a vampire type
movie, like Twilight or something.
Yeah.
Which was huge for Joe. And the real reason I was leaving the show was I did a pilot that I was going to be the lead of. It's going to be my big break. And it didn't get picked up.
Yep, and you came right back.
And I came right back.
You came crawling back. I knew it.
Well, I can't remember what was the reason that Joe came back. Was it like...
I don't know. It's a TV show.
It was just, it was dealt with, you know. It was like, oh, I don't know. It's just not happening anymore. Why are you kissing Lucy, right?
Yeah.
That was a big drama.
Do you know people still ask me if I'm from Minnesota?
Really?
Yeah.
People still ask me why I'm not dating you.
And it's like, you guys, you know.
It's like I get it, but in my head it's been so long.
But it was also a fictional television show.
Right.
So I feel like I'm always
letting people down.
Don't get me wrong. It was a fantastic television show.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
5 stars.
Hey, by the way, when I have you back on this, I'm going to come join your live.
Yeah. So I've been doing my own live. I don't have like a catchy name yet, but I've been doing them every day.
You think... I don't have a catchy name yet.
I don't.
Coffee with Kendall,
you know. Oh, Amanda Tarver. She's tuning in. Jendal forever.
Jendal forever.
I agree. Jendal
but
forever.
But what I was going to say is we should do, whether it's like this next time that you're doing a live and I jump on there or something, we should do a live viewing of an episode.
That's a great idea.
I don't know
because you know what? I feel like recently I saw a clip of the show and I was like, my voice is so high. Yeah. Like, do you feel like you sound different now? Like, yeah, when you rewatch it, I'm like, why is my voice like that?
I've seen people like comment, like if I've been doing something like this where they're like, oh, he sounds the same. And I think it's if I get like uppity, it kind of sounds the same, maybe.
Uppity?
Yeah, like if I'm doing this and I'm like kind of like cackling or laughing about something, it sounds like maybe I did on the show.
Yeah, I just feel like I'm like, whoa, my speaking voice sounds like a baby. And I didn't know that my voice would change like that.
Hey, by the way, Mika has a suggestion for your show. She just typed it in here earlier. Karate with Caitlin.
Karate with Caitlin.
Yeah.
Wasn't Joe
Joe was karate... a martial artist.
Yeah. See?
In fact,
it's in my DNA. That's a good idea, Mika. Oh,
that
Mika.
Was a show that or that show. What's wrong with me? That was a photo that I was going to share and for some reason I can't find it now. Let me see if I type our names the backwards way. And see if I can find it because it popped up last night when I was looking and it's us in those extremely oversized karate outfits. Oh, here we go.
Oh no. Oh yeah.
You know what sucks about all that is that the outfits, sometimes when I had to wear certain things or things like that, and I even looked out, like, I hated my hair, but like,
right.
Like I, as a young man, I also wanted to look cool.
Yeah.
You know, and there was times I was like, can we get like better fitting karate outfits? Like, I want to look kind of cool. You know,
I want to still look cool while I'm doing this weird karate scene.
Yeah, exactly. Like
that's funny.
It was kind of a bummer sometimes where I was like, man, this outfit's not, this isn't good.
Oh, I just thought of a good memory.
Yeah. Okay.
Remember when you guys were on tour and so was I, and we overlapped in Philadelphia? I think.
Yes, and we went and saw the parachute show.
Yes, yeah, so I was.
It was not Philadelphia, it was Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh, sorry. Yes. Yes, and you guys came to the show, and we were like, oh my God, we're in Pittsburgh together, because we're on tour, and we were like so excited, and I was like really, I was more roughing it than you guys were at that time, because y'all were stars, and still are. But you guys, you know, I had like 7 people in a van and we were like splitting some terrible hotel room somewhere.
But then right, you guys, I remember this.
Yeah, and you guys were like, well, I mean, I don't know, we can't get in trouble for it now, but you guys were like, we have 4 rooms at some nice hotel down the street and we actually have to leave tonight. So those rooms are just going to be empty if you and your band want to take them. And we were like, absolutely. And we got to take you guys' hotel rooms. And it was like the best night of our lives. We were like living like royalty.
Amanda says, still the best sleep I've ever gotten.
Still the best sleep. Yeah. Amanda was on that tour singing backup for me. And we were just like, this, it will never get better than this.
Yeah, you know what? That was so, like, I'm happy that we could do that because, of course, that's like a no-brainer, you know?
Yeah.
If we have rooms and we're leaving anyway. Yeah, we were taking off on the bus.
Yeah.
So it was like, well, yeah, just take the room keys and...
It was just the best luck we've ever had.
And by the way, like, I love how you're like, I love how you're like, well, we can't get in trouble for it now. It's, what are you actually worried about? The hotel is going to call and be like, wait.
Wait, you did what?
Yeah.
I don't know what I was thinking with that comment, but it's just retroactively my rule-following ways.
That is a great memory, though.
Yeah, that's a great memory.
I could chat forever and ever and ever, but I'm going to let you go, and I want you to let me know when I can... What did it... What?
Anyone else? Are you there?
I'm here.
Okay. Sorry, I was reading a comment. You froze.
Okay. Did I freeze freeze in a good position?
Yeah, you did, but I was okay. Like, is this gonna be the end? Because that's just my worst fear.
Well then let's call it. Okay.
You're gonna come on my live show and perform some songs.
Okay.
Woo!
Okay, you got it.
And yeah, go check out
we're still here.
Is it delayed now?
No, oh I don't know.
All right.
Go check out Feel Bad. Caitlin Tarver, Feel Bad. I love you.
Thanks, Kendall. Love you.
Soon. Come on, Instagram. Get it together.
All right. Bye.
Bye-bye. Well, I hope. What's going on? Mika, am I frozen? Am I frozen now?
No.
So, if I go like this and I do a thumbs up, am I still on? I have this picture of Caitlin's frozen from when I signed off, and now, yeah, that's funny. Now I have she's staring at me. um. Okay. Well, hopefully this works. I'm going to play a song and then I'm going to sign off. And okay. So we'll see if this, will you tell me if anything changes? Well, this is weird because I don't know if you guys are still watching or not, but I'm going to play a song and hopefully you are. Is it still going? That's so weird. You got to see this. Look at, how am I supposed to play like this? We take a picture so she can see it. Okay.
Wait, let me get the phone out of the way.
So wait, are people still watching? Is
yes,
it fine?
It's totally fine.
Okay, go back so I can see.
No, I swear it's totally fine. And everybody's saying, like, keep going. It's
okay.
Totally fine.
Okay. All right, I'm going to play a song. And here, stay nearby so I can make sure. I just hope it doesn't record that version. That's funny.
That's a good point. It might. Maybe you should.
Well, no, because it's going to play on Instagram, like,
yeah,
my
yeah,
phone is frozen.
Yeah.
But if it does, okay, whatever. Hey, so I'm going to play a Big Time Rush song. This is called No Idea, for those of you who don't know. And, yeah, so it's going to be fun. And it's, I didn't warm up too much. Always important to remember, never warm up before singing. That's not true. Always warm up before singing. Okay, here we go. Okay.
I love ya. If you ain't got nobody to love, adore ya. There's no one to do.
I want to get it. It's too funny. I can't do it. Sing to her. Sing
okay,
to
I'll sing.
Joe.
I'll sing to Joe.
Sing to Joe.
Okay, here we go.
Come on now.
I'm just okay. Okay, I can't.
Deep breath.
I can't. I don't want to laugh again. All right.
I love ya. You ain't got nobody to love. Girl, adore ya. There's no one but the Lord. And I'll show you.
it's so ridiculous.
Oh my gosh.
Oh.
You have to do it because your voice is an angel. It's so good when you're practicing.
All right. Well, don't film anymore. Don't film anymore. Stop. Okay. This is something.
I love ya. Got nobody to love. Girl, adore ya. There's no one to adore. And I'll show you. Hey, there's no one to show. Oh, I know you. You ain't want somebody to know. Oh, 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 yeah. Every time you come around, you put a lightning bolt on my face. Baby, every time you come around, girl, you take my breath away. And I just want to be gone until I take you. Cause I want you to be gone until you take me. But the truth is she has no idea, no idea that I'm even here. I'm even here. She has no idea, no idea that's standing here.
Rough for me because I still have Caitlin staring at me. Can you take, just so everyone can see what we're talking about, can you take a picture and then turn your phone and show, just so everyone has an idea of what I'm dealing with right now.
So that everyone can see that you just sang No Idea to Caitlin's in love face. Okay.
Okay, now show, and this is, we're going to sign off after this because we're getting close to 1 hour. So that's what I'm staring at, everybody. Oh, okay. Well, I'm out of here. I was going to talk to some people, but if I do, we'll run out of time and they'll shut off the live anyway. So I'm assuming you guys were still watching. I don't see that here, and I didn't get.
Lots of really lovely comments.
Okay, good. I'm gonna go for that song again sometime soon and warm up more and practice it more. Because I want to do better. I want to do better than I did.
My whole body is shaking. I'm crying. OMG, BTR reunion. Just when I think I'm out, this guy pulls me back in. Don't be out. I'm going to run into your Gart. Kendall, you're such an inspiration to me.
Oh, thank you, everybody. Well, look, I'm glad you were still watching, and hopefully this records the proper way. So, Instagram, get it together. Everybody else, you're doing a great job. And Caitlin, thank you for joining me. And I hope you guys had a great time on Coffee with Kendall. We'll speak soon. Bye-bye.